New year, new lots. Usually we have a laundry list of changes to tell you about on January 1st, but COVID-19 prevented lawmakers from meeting most of last year. CBS2's Lauren Victory is here to explain why the Illinois House and Senate might not be able to get anything done in 2021. This is a catch-22, Lauren.
That's right, Marie. A veto session in November was canceled because of COVID concerns. And as it stands, Illinois lawmakers need to meet in person to vote. It's something they haven't done for more than 7 months.
We're in a pandemic.
May 2020, face shields on, masked up. Illinois legislators got down to brass tacks after COVID-19 kept them away from the Capitol for 2 months.
And that was good in that it allowed them to conduct some business.
With little business since. No bills voted on in more than half a year during a pandemic that affects every single voter.
There's talk of borrowing billions of dollars from the federal government. How is that borrowing going to be paid back?
Lawrence Massal of the nonpartisan government watchdog group, the Civic Federation, explains Illinois lawmakers could conduct their sessions via Zoom, but some might challenge a virtual vote in court. Passing a law to allow yays or nays over the internet could get around that, but presents a problem.
They can't approve remote legislating without being in person.
Well, that's true.
We were told to be back in the chamber on Friday the 8th.
Representative Ann Williams plans to push hard for her remote legislating bill if the General Assembly meets next week as planned. A similar bill failed in the House in May.
I've been talking to my colleagues on both sides of the aisle, and I think there is an openness to moving forward now.
Legislators in Pennsylvania, California, and Colorado approved voting from home months ago.
At least 22 other states have been operating virtually or remotely during the pandemic. More are likely to be joined. Only Illinois, from our standpoint, has been resistant.
Representative Williams stresses that she prefers to meet in person. She thinks her and her colleagues do their best work when they're together in person. But she adds that this bill is necessary so they can vote from home in extreme circumstances, i.e. a pandemic. We should add that the Senate passed their own version of this bill earlier in 2020, and they've been able to hold committee meetings virtually. I'm Lauren Victory, CBS 2 News.